Hey there, it's James Taylor, keynote speaker on creativity, innovation, and future trends. Today, I'm in beautiful Austin, Texas, and I'm here because I've just come off stage speaking for a company called Puratos. They're one of the leading kind of suppliers of ingredients for baking industry, for baking products, chocolate products, patisserie. They provide, if you go into many stores, retailers, if you go into many department stores, supermarkets, many of the products in those places, the actual ingredients themselves come from Puratos. So I was here, they brought some of their top clients here to this beautiful place here in Cedar Creek, in just outside of Austin. And I just spoke to them today about three technologies that are going to really change the food industry. So three big innovations that are kind of going on just now that are gonna affect the future of food. So let me tell you about what they are just now. The first area was talking about something called precision fermentation. Now this is a company called Solar Foods. I'll put a link here as well. A Finnish company who were tasked with how to make food in space. Really cool job, how to make food in space. And they use a technique called precision fermentation. And to make this flour, it's called Solene. And what's incredible about this flour is 70% protein, 8% fats, fibers and minerals, all the things that you would need. And you can use it to make baked goods products and breads and pasta, plant-based meat alternatives, dairy alternatives, for example. But get this, to the amount of land required to use this technique of precision fermentation to make food is tiny compared to the way that we do agriculture today. It's been estimated that land the size of London or Greater London would be enough land if you put these precision factories on there to feed the entire world. That's how much. Now, obviously, you're not going to do London, take over London. But if you think about the amount of land we use today for agriculture and for growing food and making food, it's huge. It's immense. So there's ability just to get a little bit more, a bit more innovative in terms of food production and making food at scale, because we've got to feed 8 billion people. That's how many people are on the planet now. Second technology I spoke about was precision formulation. Now, precision formulation is the ability that we have to use things like artificial intelligence to augment the work of innovation labs. See, at the moment, the way that most food innovation companies or their innovation labs have to work is they have scientists, food technicians, agronomists perhaps as well, in getting involved in creating these ideas for new recipes. Now, that's a manual process, a slow process. So what we can do today is, using artificial intelligence, machine learning, we can essentially feed data into different types of machine learning and using our algorithms to look and creating all different types of recipes and ingredients and formulations that we possibly couldn't, you know, go through before. And then what we can do is, because we can also start to test for, you know, how good will these be without ever having making them. So how good will they be from a sustainability perspective? How good will they be from a taste, a crispness, all these different areas as well. So this allows us to really fast, to speed up the process of food innovation. Something that could have taken months or years or sometimes decades to create, to discover new types of ways of making things, we can do it in a matter of really weeks and months now. So it's kind of very interesting time that we're at. Now, the other third technology that I was kind of speaking about today, so I spoke about precision fermentation, precision formulation, and the final thing was around perennial crops. Because the way that most food is grown today is that farmers plant crops on an annual basis. Wheat, grain, soybeans, all the corn, all these kind of things, they're kind of planted on an annual basis, and you have to till the land, grind up the land, you know, every year. So there's, what I was sharing today was some new technologies that are kind of coming about and new innovations that have come about from labs based here in the US, who have been able to ensure that we can have what we call more perennial crops. This means that you can plant types of wheat, perennial types of wheat and grain, that rather than have to till the land every year, you're able to, they can be left in there, the root system grows much longer. It actually sequesters carbon instead of causing carbon as well. And it just means you have to use less fertilizer, less nitrogen, less phosphates are kind of coming off. So it's just much more sustainable to be able to do this. Now, this is a technology, an innovation that they've been working for 40 years on developing, and they finally cracked it. They finally got the yield required to be able to do it. So those are the three technologies I'm personally really excited around in food. This was a great event. They had all of their clients here from all over the US, some of the big food retailers, food production companies, baked goods companies. We had a really good time, and I was sharing also ways about how to use like generative AI in the kind of work that they do in food production. And it's a really exciting time to be in the food industry, because we're starting to use some of these technologies to kind of fast forward things a little bit, just work a little bit smarter. Food waste is a big problem, especially in kind of commercial kitchens. So I was also talking about how innovation, more creative thinking could be applied to that. And I showed some examples of what they're doing in Dubai now in terms of food waste. So from here, this is absolutely scorching hot today here in Austin, in Texas. This afternoon, I fly on to Memphis, where I'm gonna be next, and in Orlando and in Abu Dhabi, 2 days after that, and in Barcelona. So keep following me along. If you're not subscribed to any of the channels or wherever you're watching this, make sure you just click on that subscribe, follow along. And from here in beautiful Austin, Texas, my name's James Taylor. Thanks for watching.